Hi, thanks for visiting Graphic Illusion. This is the origin issue of Captain Atom. In reality, the material inside may have been printed in a different magazine, a comic book prior to this, but I like the idea that it's number 75 of Strange Suspense Stories, June 1965, all by Steve Ditko. And it's an origin and everything, so that's a very wonderful thing. Price guide's around $200 for near mint. I'm asking $250 because it's a childhood treasure. It's in pretty nice shape. It's not mint, but it definitely is fine. It's a very fine range with a little bit of wear right down here on the front cover. And since I'm attached to it for some reason, I won't tell you why, that's my minimum price. May go down to $200 someday if I needed money, but I'd rather have it in my collection for now. And the great thing about it is when Ditko does it, he really does it well. I'm double checking here because I felt like maybe there was another page right there. It's really hard to do in one hand. Zoom. Zoom, zoom. Yep, there was. There we are. This one over here, this one page. Not Ditko. A one-page story, but everything else in this book apparently so far is Steve Ditko, the creator of Doctor Strange and Spider-Man with Stan Lee. And why did we love Captain Atom as a kid? Many good reasons. One of them is that he was so space-oriented that if you read a Captain Atom comic book at night, you'd probably have dreams of floating and flying. A lot of ads back then. Advertising is actually considered black magic. You think propaganda is even worse? Look at that. Now, when you see all the nebulas from Hubble Space, I mean, comics really don't compare to that. But when you're a kid and you're flying like that, there's a freedom. You're not being tortured by family or friends or random other kids on the way to school. You're reading comic books and you're using your imagination. Not only are you reading, but you're enjoying art. You're learning perspective. I could go on and on, and I have in my other 250 plus videos on YouTube. Again, I'm Graphic Illusion. Come visit my site, http://, graphic-illusion.com. I'm also on eBay under the same name, but you can always buy directly from me. Here's one that is not Ditko called Out of This World. Has my stomach growling because I don't eat breakfast. I should. Everybody says it's really good to eat breakfast, but I think I'd be dead by now if I did. I like a large lunch, like the former Pope. This almost looks a little Severinistic there, that face right there. And so from the imaginative field of mind comes Captain Atom, origin issue. Strange Suspense Stories, number 75. And because I have that one out, I have the next one out too, which I keep them all in this sort of hard plastic top loaders. What a great Ditko in that, Captain Atom, I'll tell you that. One of my favorites. And this one's one of my favorites too, Strange Suspense Stories, number 77. I'll probably always keep these two. And apparently I'm going to now sell this one. It's sold to some guy back east. And it's worth 70 to 90 in the price guide. Based on the fact that it isn't perfect mint, I'm just letting him have it for 50, and I'm even paying the shipping, so he's getting it for 45 from a personal collection, owned a really long time. And it looks like it even has the blue beetle. Well, no deal is set until I receive the cash, so it could still be someone else's. Have an excellent day. I'm going to check out what Overstreet says on Captain Adam number 83. I spent a lot of time doing this. This is the latest Overstreet. It's just one of the versions of the cover. And hey, I turned right to Captain Adam. How exciting is that? And let's see here. Charlton Comics. And number 83.